Okay, that's Duzama for fun, and here I have this question for you guys. And this is from the Harvard MIT map competition. We are going to find the smallest positive integer n, so that this expression is an integer. Wow, because we have a square root here instead of a square root, and we have another one. We actually have done a video on the cube root situation like this. That expression gave us an integer. So we have a pretty good hope for this, right? Anyway, as always, please pause the video and try this first. Okay, you did it? Good, if you did, that's really good, and let me know. Okay, let's see how we can do it. So, perhaps, typically, we can just call this to be, let's say, k.
Let k equal this.
And perhaps let me just indicate that k is an integer. Alright, because we have square roots, so maybe it's a good idea to just square both sides. So let's go ahead and do so right here. And we are getting k squared is equal to this thing squared, which is just 100 plus square root of n, plus 2 times this and that, which is just 2 square root. And then we have the inside times inside, which will give us 100 squared, which is 1,000, I mean 10,000, and then minus n. And then we add this thing squared, which is 100 minus square root of n. And this is actually pretty nice because this and that cancel, and we can combine the hundreds. So k squared is equal to 200 plus 2 times the square root of 10,000 minus n. So it looks pretty easy right now, right? And let me just show you guys why I did at first. Because I thought it was just that easy. Because this is the only problem that we have, huh? Because if this square root gives us an integer, then the whole thing is an integer. So this is what I did. Notice that I'm not going to choose n is equal to 0 because n has to be positive. But if you look at that, this is just 100 squared. So I made this, I set this to be square root of 99 squared because we are taking away, you know, n from there. Well, 99 squared is the same as 9801. So I'm just going to do 10,000 minus n, and I set it equal 9801, and solve this, and we get n is equal to 199. Done deal. That's it. Thank you guys. No. This is wrong. Take a look. If you put this back to the original expression, unfortunately, it doesn't give us an integer. Yeah, that's bad. Sorry. And let's talk about why. If we put this back here, yes, we just get 99 squared instead of the square root, so we have 99 times 2, and then plus 200. That's 490-something. No, 398. Unfortunately, that is not a perfect square because you see, we have k squared is equal to this. So we do have to pay attention to the left-hand side. So now we have to make more observations. The first one is the following. K squared is equal to 200 plus 2 times that. We can factor out 2. So this right here will tell us k squared has to be even. And because k squared is even, this right here implies, and it's actually like a bidirection if you would like, k is even. Okay, so just keep that in mind. Okay, now the other thing that we have to talk about is, what if n was just equal to 0? Then that was the easiest case, right? Because we just get square root of 100 plus square root of 100, and that's going to be give us 20. So that would be 20, and if we square both sides, then we know we will just get 20 squared here, yeah. But we don't get 20 squared. Yeah, we don't get 20 squared. Why? Because again, n has to be positive. Now, the biggest this right here could be was 20 squared, what k is equal to 20. But we know k is even, and we are taking away a little bit. So the next thing that we can get is, in fact, we have to work out when k is equal to 18. Alright, again, the biggest right here, the biggest And technically, this is not achievable because n cannot be equal to 0. So the biggest was 20 squared, but that's when n is equal to 0, but this is not achievable. So we go to the next one, the previous even number, right? So 18, that's our consideration. So we are just going to make this equal to 18, and then we just plug that back. So we have 18 squared. So 18 squared, and that's equal to 200 plus 2 square root of. Yeah, just solve this equation now, and that's pretty much it. So let's see, 18 squared is 324, minus 200 is 124, and divided by 2 is 62. And then we make that equal to the square root, 10,000 minus n. And of course, we can just do the usual business, square both sides, and then work this out, right? And I'll just tell you guys that n is equal to 6,156. Seriously? You're asking for the smallest integer n, and then the smallest answer is 6,156? Really? Yeah, really, because if you put this back there, yes, we get our integer. Yep. If you like solving different types of math problems and want to learn more, then you should check out our sponsor today, Brilliant. Brilliant is an excellent online learning platform with a big focus on interactive learning. They have over 60 interactive courses in math, science, and computer science. This is from their Mathematical Fundamentals course. We can see how they provide visualization and animation to difference of two squares and not just the algebraic manipulations. Once you interact with the lesson, the concept will just stick with you much better. I can tell you that taking a course from Brilliant is really, really fun because they always keep you engaged by storytelling and beautiful animations. On top of that, they have courses for every student, ranging from algebra to college calculus and even more. And the best part is, if you use the link in the description, brilliant.org/blackpenredpen, then you can get 20% off discount. So go ahead and check them out, and I want to thank Brilliant for sponsoring this video. So now I have another question for you guys. Is it possible for us to find the biggest negative integer n so that the same expression gives us an integer? And we notice, when n is negative, this right here is complex. So what do you think? I'm going to leave this to you guys. Wow.